is quite limited. I mean, we the student only has like around 33 respondent. Okay, very small group number of respondent because this is an individual project. Okay, not a group project. Okay, so the number of sample size is quite small, but nevertheless, okay, the main purpose is to show you how to do some of the analysis, and of course, okay, you cannot rely on me on how to use SPSS. You have YouTube's, okay, blogs, whatever lah, that you can, especially YouTube, okay, that you can find some tips or guides how to how to use the basic functions of SPSS to do the analysis. Okay, so I will just show you the basic one, okay, based on what we have discussed on the last lecture, okay, how you need to what you need to do to remodify lah, to modify your research question so that whatever analysis and also the hypothesis that you want to test, okay, will be suitable lah, okay, for you to. Okay, so yesterday, I mean, this is just a quick snapshot. So some of the thesis which I think you can refer to, okay, thesis number 20, 57 and 23. So if you go through this thesis, so you can see that how the student prepared, I mean the 27, where is it? 27. Okay, I just open one lah. Okay, and then the rest you can refer to the. So basically, the why I'm referring to this video is 20. Okay, not 27. Number 20. Okay, this one. Okay, so if you look at some of the thesis which I've shown in this part here, 20, 57 and 23, okay, so this selected thesis, these are master's thesis, okay, whereby there are different ways where you can actually put the hypothesis testing. Okay, some students they put in chapter 3, some they put in chapter 2, okay, because there is no strict guideline, okay, or strict format where you need to. But of course, the format chapter 2 will be your literature review and also your theoretical review, okay, of the theory. But you can follow this few thesis, okay, which I showed just now, 20, 57 and 23. Okay, so for example, thesis number 20, okay, at the end of chapter 2, the student put the hypothesis testing. I mean, put the hypothesis, not hypothesis testing, put the hypothesis that the thesis is about to test lah, meaning based on the research question, basically. Okay, so in your case, okay, it depends on how, on what you prepared for research question number 2 and research question number 3 lah. Okay, if you look at the video which I prepared the last time, okay, so if you are going to do a hypothesis testing for, let's say you want to look at whether there is a whether gender, okay, the whether for example gender or okay, for example gender has any influence on, for example, the intention to use online platform, for example, so you are comparing between gender, male versus female. So that will be your, for example, your first hypothesis lah. Okay, so, or if you want to look at whether different programs, okay, whether the student who belong to different programs, economic, finance, banking or whatever, depending on the scope again lah of your thesis, I'm just giving you an example. Okay, whether student from different programs has different impact on career choice, for example. Okay, so you want to do ANOVA testing, for example. So that will be another hypothesis. Okay, so it doesn't need to follow strictly this style. Okay, you can look at other thesis how to actually put your hypothesis testing. Okay, so again, this is based on what you find from the from the sample of journals or any other thesis lah, okay, that you can find. But I think many of the thesis that you can find from the Google Drive, okay, will be more than sufficient, okay, if for you to use as guideline. Okay, for example, this one, okay, thesis number 57. Okay, so the student just puts a simple, okay, research hypothesis. So you can have more than, I mean, depending on how many tests that you want to do. Okay, even though you only have three research questions, okay, the first research question is about the demographic analysis. Okay, the second research question is for you to use the two sample hypothesis testing. Okay, whereby the third research question is for you to use ANOVA. Okay, I know many of you pun dah lupa lah apa benda ke whatever that we discussed 2 weeks ago. Okay, not 2 weeks ago lah, a week, slightly more than 1 week ago. So go back and check the video lah. Okay, so for example, for research question number two, if you are going to use the two sample hypothesis testing, okay, the t-test, okay, if you're going to use the t-test, okay, so let's say you want to do two t-tests, okay, two analysis t-tests, okay, two t-test analysis, so meaning you are going to have two hypothesis testing lah for each one. Okay, for example, one is for gender, okay, comparing between male and female, and for example, the other hypothesis testing is you want to look at, for example, between married and unmarried. Okay, if your sample ada married and unmarried lah. Okay, but if your sample only focus on student, let's say you want to compare between depending lah. I cannot say for right now. Okay, what is so if only one test is suitable, but if you only can do one hypothesis, one t test, then just use one t test. Okay, because for example, if your data yang ada dua grouping is only male and female, the rest more than three groups, for example programs, of course there are more than two programs lah in SAB, okay, or colleges. Okay, colleges in UM there are three colleges, okay, fine, CAS, COB, Colgis. So you cannot do t-test is only meant for two groups. Okay, so if you look at your demographic questionnaire, what information that you classify only for two groups, for example male and female, okay, or any other groupings that only has two types of groupings. Okay, so if you if only one question that relates to that provide two groups, male and female, then you can only provide one t-test lah. Okay, so but for the third one, for the third research question, I think then you need to have at least three or four hypothesis testing lah, okay, based on what I discussed. So this again go back to your questionnaire. Okay, how many Likert skill questions you have? Let's say you have four Likert skill sections. Okay, one is one Likert skill section for one factor, untuk satu faktor which influence the career choice. Then meaning you can do up to four hypothesis testing using ANOVA. Okay, so again, I'm not going to repeat this because I already discussed that on our last video. Okay, so you can refer to thesis 57, for example. Okay, how to construct your hypothesis lah. Okay, so and so you can include your hypothesis in your chapter number 2. So when you do the testing in when you present the analysis in chapter number 4, so whatever that you plan, whatever that you test, okay, and present the output in chapter number 4, you already mentioned what are the hypotheses that you plan to actually test earlier in chapter number 2. So in chapter number 4, when you mention, when you state what are the hypotheses that you are testing, so because you cannot put the hypothesis testing first time in chapter number 4, okay, you can repeat the hypothesis testing in chapter number 4, but you must mention that hypothesis earlier. Okay, so some thesis put in chapter number 2, some thesis even put in chapter number 1. Okay, but I will prefer you to follow, for example, thesis number 57 style 20 or 23. Okay, each of these thesis, they put the hypothesis testing, the hypothesis, okay, on in chapter number 2 lah. Okay, so this will be, I think, the simplest format, meaning you just outline what are the hypotheses that you plan to test like this, okay, at the end of your chapter number 2 lah. Okay, so that is on the hypothesis write-up, okay, where you should outline your hypothesis. Okay, so once you are clear what you want to test, so then chapter 4 will be just following what you plan to test, okay, based on, so again, whatever that you put here must reflect back your research questions, okay, your research question number, especially research question number 2 and research question number 3. Research question number 1, there is no hypothesis testing, because research question number 1 is just to explore, to determine the demographic characteristics of your sample. Okay, so you want to just use pie chart, bar chart. So for that kind of analysis, there is no hypothesis testing required. Okay, so there is no hypothesis for research question number 1. So only research question number 2 and research question number 3. So for each of the research question number 2 and 3, you may have more than 3, 4 hypotheses, okay, depending on what you want to test lah. Okay, so you can follow this. Okay, so again, go back and watch the video on our last lecture on the previous Thursday, okay, before we had our 1 week break lah, not break lah, okay, tak ada kelas last week. Okay, so that is on a bit on that lah. Okay, so the file which I sent you on your WhatsApp, okay, on this, adakan file ni kan? Ke saya tak bagi lagi? Ke you all yang tak buka lagi ke apa? You all kalau tanya semua tak nak jawab, semua senyap saja. Tidur ke saya pun tak tahu. Fabian? Mana Fabian?
Ya, yes, sir.
Ha, file ni you all ada kan? Saya dah bagi kan?
Ada, ada.
Okay, so just, okay. Okay, so this file which I sent you, okay, the you can actually understand quite easily lah. Okay, I think the thesis or the report for this also is given in your WhatsApp. Okay, so you can read just get an idea lah, overall idea what the items in the questionnaire is about. But basically it's about the cost of living among for the UPSB or the support staff, okay, in UUM. Okay, so if you look at the on this value here, okay, so on this value is where you know whether the question is based on nominal, ordinal or scale. Okay, so if you recall back what you learn in your basic statistics, okay, if the question, for example, male and female, okay, so male and female is based on nominal scale lah. Okay, so even though this student put ordinal here, okay, but you can always change to the original one was ordinal, okay, sorry, this one is supposed to be nominal. So if you cannot put ranking, okay, ranking means high, low, medium, okay, or for example based on income range, okay, male and female is supposed to be a nominal scale, okay, because there is no ordering, there is no, you cannot say that male must be first, female second, okay, so that is nominal data. Ordinal is when your data can be categorized into ranking. For example, education level. Okay, education level, you know that primary school is the lowest one. Diploma and above will be the highest level. So, 1 will be the lowest, 4 will be the highest. So, for education level, for example, it's supposed to be ordinal. okay, because you can rank the category from lower, from low to high. Okay, the same thing if you put the income in this way. For example, this value will be the lowest one and this will be the highest one. So why it's important for you to declare the kind of the type of data that you have, so that when you run your analysis, okay, SPSS will know what I mean, the structure of your data lah. Okay, so you need to know the, and of course lah, part of the submission of your thesis, I mean of your project, okay, I want to look at your file as well lah, your SPSS file. Okay, how you key in, okay, how you define your data, so that will be part of the project submission as well. Okay, so make sure that you define your data properly. Okay, scale. Okay, scale data, you cannot, if you put 1, 2, 3, 4, this is not scale data. Scale data, for example, if you ask what is your CGPA, for example, okay, and the student write down 3.2, okay, in the question. Okay, so if that value is provided directly by the respondent, okay, you ask what is your CGPA and you put 3.3 or 2.8 or whatever value, and you key in the exact value of that CGPA in your data. Okay, so that will be a scale data. Scale data mean it can start from, again, from 0 up to 4, I mean up to whatever value lah. So for pointer, okay, because the data is raw data like that, okay, so you need to define CGPA as a scale data lah. Okay, the same thing, for example, if you ask how much do you spend, okay, as long as the value is, you don't categorize the value into 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, into groupings. Okay, if your data is based on grouping like this, it can either be nominal or ordinal. Okay, but usually when you categorize like this, it must be an ordinal data lah, because 1 is the lowest one, 4 is the highest rank data lah. Okay, it's just like if you go to a hotel and the hotel asks you to rank the quality of the service, low, medium, good, for example, not satisfactory, satisfactory, very satisfied or whatever lah. Okay, so as you go higher into the ranking, the better is the value. So the same goes if you define your answer based on grouping like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means the value is higher than the value on 1. So this kind of data must be declared as ordinal. Okay, but for gender, married or unmarried, single, bachelor, for example, okay, like this, okay, this is defined as nominal, because you cannot say single is better or married is better than being single or whatever lah. Okay, the same goes with race, okay, Malay, Chinese, Indian. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, you cannot say that okay, 1 is better than 2 or 2 is better than 1 or vice versa. Okay, so for race, it must be defined as nominal as well. So you need to understand the type of category when you create your data based on category like this. Okay, if the ranking is, if there is no particular ranking in your data, it should be defined as nominal lah. Okay, if there is if the ranking, if the data can be understood as there is a meaningful ranking, okay, then, for example, education just now, okay, then it must be defined as ordinal. Okay, but if your data takes, when you key in your data not based on category like this, but on raw data, okay, you, what is your age, for example, okay, you put the age as 21 or 23 or 20, so meaning the exact value, so it must be defined as scale data. Okay, what is your CGPA, how much do you, what is your monthly income, what is your gross income, for example. Okay, so if the value of your income is key in as the actual value, for example, 2,800 ringgit, okay, so you key in 2,800 in your data, then meaning that particular question must be defined as scale data lah. So basically scale, when you define as scale, the value must be an raw value, okay, not categorized into ranking 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1. Okay, when you put ranking, and when you put category in the values, okay, it must be defined as none lah, basically. So in other words, if you put value as none here, okay, you don't define any value labels. So in other words, you are telling SPSS this data should be a skill data lah. Okay, so that will be the easiest way to understand. Okay, so that is in terms of defining your data, whether it must be nominal, ordinal, or skill data. Okay, for Likert skill questions, okay, whatever Likert skill, for example, in this particular example, the student has 1, 2, 3, okay, 3 Likert skill sections, section B, section C, and section D. Okay, you can look at the report, okay, to look at the actual questions, okay, in short, there are 3 groups of Likert skill, okay, to answer different categories, okay, according to the research scope lah, okay, if your thesis is about factor that influence career choice, so there are 4 factors that influence the career choice, so then there you will have 4 Likert skill section lah, one section for one factor. Okay, so at least you must have 3 lah, okay, so that you can do different analysis with your Likert skill sections. Okay, so that is on this Likert skill section. Okay, so question that based on Likert skill, okay, basically you must define as not nominal, okay, you must define as ordinal, because okay, we know that 1 versus 5, okay, 5 sangat setuju, you strongly agree, okay, strongly agree is meaning that on the scale this is better than strongly disagree lah. So in term of the ranking of the value, this will take highest value than number 1. Okay, so for all Likert skill question, it must be defined as ordinal. Okay, so not nominal lah. Okay, it must be defined as ordinal. Okay, so you need to define your Likert skill question according to ordinal. Okay, because when you put scale 1 to 5, 5 meaning the highest value, okay, 1 meaning the lowest value, okay, strongly disagree versus strongly agree. Okay, so that is how you should declare your data in SPSS when it comes to Likert skill question. Okay, this must be in ordinal form lah. Okay. Okay, so these are the things that you need to modify lah. Okay, or pay attention. Okay, when you create your own set of SPSS file, okay, remember that. Okay, to declare the category of your the measure of your data. Okay, correctly. Okay, so that is on the Likert skill question. So I mentioned in the previous, in our last lecture, okay, the first research question is just basically on the simple analysis on the demographic factors, okay, whereby you can use the simple descriptive statistics. Okay, you can explore on these descriptive statistics, okay, see what kind of information, okay, that you can get, okay, besides using simple bar graph. Okay, you can go to frequencies. Okay, here you can see, for example, different. Okay, you can have, so this is your try and error punya ni lah. Okay, on the charts option, okay, you can use whatever, but again, I think I mentioned on your last video or your last lecture, okay, do not use the automatic graph created by SPSS, okay, because it looks pretty ugly lah. Okay, so you need to recreate, or okay, you can extract the data from from SPSS, okay, take the frequency or whatever data that you can extract, okay, transfer them into Excel, okay, and create a better looking graph lah, whether you are using histogram, bar chart, pie chart or whatever, okay. You can modify in SPSS, but it takes a much longer time to do. So better to use Excel, okay, extract the, so I think I mentioned this before, okay. So another thing that you can do in your research question number one, when it comes to analysis of the demographic characteristics of your sample, you can also use cross tabulation, okay, cross tab, whereby you can cross two variable and you can get more information. Okay, for example, if you cross between age, for example, you cross between gender versus education, for example, okay. Then meaning that you can get more information, how many female and male based on education level, rather than you do a simple pie chart based on how many male, how many female. Okay, of course you can do that as well, but if you want, but meaning that these are the things that you can explore. Okay, but don't put too many bar chart ke histogram ke cross tabulation ke. There must be a limit lah. Okay. Meaning that you need to know how much that you want to discuss. If you keep on repeating the same stuff over and over again pun, tak guna. Okay, there's no point. Okay, so again, this is based on what you can refer to past thesis, past journals. See what other people do. Okay, what are the information that you need to extract? Okay, when it comes to the demographic information. Okay, what information should you present? Okay. Don't provide too many graphs, too many histogram or pie charts, when then it becomes berulang-ulang lah, repetitive. Okay, so if you can find maybe two or three histogram, one or two cross tabulation, that should be and it has provided enough information about the demographic factor of your or characteristics of your samples, that should be sufficient lah. Okay, so presentation of your output, okay, the whatever lah, kamu nak pakai the 3D or non-3D, simple layout, simple color, whatever. So it will again lah, okay, affect the overall quality, okay, and at the end of the day, the marks of your project lah, okay, how you display your table, okay. So it doesn't need to be too flashy, maknanya too colourful. Okay, academic report no need to be too colourful. Okay, but it must look professional enough. So again, okay, go to look at journals, how authors create or present their findings. Okay, their output when it comes to using graphs, okay, pie chart, histogram. What are the common style lah that you can use? Okay. For PowerPoint presentation, yes, you can. For the video presentation, you can use colorful whatever. Okay, but when it comes to report, okay, you need to minimize on this benda-benda yang terlampau fancy lah. Not to be too fancy. Okay. So again, okay, there is no particular format. I mean, terpulang on your creativity. Okay, but stick to the normal style lah, okay, when it comes to academic punya reporting. Okay, look at the thesis in the Google Drive for you to get more idea lah, okay, how to present your pie chart, histogram and whatnot. Okay, so that is for research question number one, which I think I already mentioned in our last video. Okay, so second and the third. Okay, so today I think I will discuss more on the second. We'll see lah whether we can finish second and third today, okay, and then maybe on next class maybe we can do we can proceed on discussing chapter number four. Okay, but basically what we are doing is actually already crossing chapter number four already. Okay, because when we start discussing on we already discussed what you need to do on chapter number 3 lah, okay, in the research method. Okay, research method, we already discussed that, okay, on the scope, on the population, okay, using the Cretchy-Morgan table, Okay, so you can use this the same thesis which I shown before. Okay, in okay, what is your population frame? What is your how many sample are you going to collect based on the Cressy-Morgan table? Okay, so how many? What is your sample size? Okay, so these are the information that you need to present when it comes to chapter number 3. Okay, so what will be the if you're going to use ANOVA, for example, ANOVA and also the t-test, so that need to be mentioned as well lah in your chapter number 3. So chapter number 3 is quite short basically, and actually yeah, the main information that I want to look is how you actually obtain what is the sample size. Okay, what is your population? Okay, how do you group them? What is the grouping of your population? And at the end of the day, how many samples that you expect to extract, okay, or obtain from your total, from your population, which need to be based on actual values. Okay, so I don't need to remind you on that again. Okay, so these are the information that I'm looking, I will pay more attention to lah. Okay, because the rest is, I think, is just when you go through the thesis on okay, the look at all the thesis that you have in the Google Drive or any other sources, okay, journals, you find that when it comes to chapter number 3, okay, is pretty much very simple, okay, not dia tak banyak macam chapter number 2 or chapter number 1. Okay, chapter 1 you have to present your problem statement. Okay, your research question, your introduction, your background. So there's a lot of things going on in chapter 1 and also chapter number 2. Okay, your literature review and also your theoretical section, okay, in chapter number 2. But chapter number 3 is pretty much straightforward. Okay, what is your population? What is your sample? Where you get your data from? What is the unit of analysis? Okay. And then, okay, you define what is your sample, what is your population size, okay, and at the end of the day, what is the technique that you are going to use, okay, in order to analyze your data, okay, whether you are using ANOVA, okay, some of the analysis may not be relevant to you. For example, okay, I did mention this before. In the actual research, if you're doing, let's say one day when you do your project paper in semester 7, your thesis, your kertas ilmiah, okay, then, for example, your data must be the actual data lah, not a dummy data that you do this semester, okay, and then when it comes to actual research, you need to do what we call as pilot test or reliability test of your questionnaire. So you need to present this Cromwell alpha value, okay, which will tell you whether your questionnaire, is it good enough? Okay, is your questionnaire reliable or not? So these are part of the standard reporting when it comes to if you are using primary data from questionnaire. Okay, if your data is based on regression, econometric regression, the OLS, the one that you learn in your basic econometric, Cromwell alpha ni not relevant lah, because this is only for questionnaire type of analysis. Okay, so if you're doing correlation, for example, yes, I mean, I'm not going to tell you what you can do, what you cannot do. Okay, so this is up to your own creativity, what you can obtain from what you can actually understand, I mean, take from all the examples from other thesis. If you find that those analysis is relevant to you and you can do that, okay, you can include that in your thesis as well, in your project. Okay, but for Cromwell alpha, it's not relevant lah, because you're not going to do the act, because this is only meant for if you are doing actual data collection. Okay, meaning that you go to the you do the actual data collection either from Google Form or face-to-face interview, whatever method, but those data must be the real data. Okay, bukan data yang tipu-tipu yang you all buat sekarang lah. Okay, so these are the techniques. If you are using ANOVA, so you need to mention lah ANOVA here lah in your chapter number 3. okay, what is ANOVA, okay, how do you actually use the ANOVA, what are the characteristics. So provide a simple description of ANOVA test, okay. Okay, so that is on chapter number 3. And then chapter number 4 is basically presenting your analysis lah. Okay, so pretty much answering all the research questions that you outline in chapter number 1. Okay, so I will go through, I think, chapter number 4 maybe next week. Okay, I will go through, I mean, maybe select few theses. Maybe some of them, the one that you see today, okay, which I think is quite simple to follow lah. Okay, how you present, okay, the kind of sentences, the choice of words, okay, that you need to follow, okay, and then the type of graph. You can see that the graph here is very simple, not to apa tu, yalah, tak ada, no, dia bukan ada color as what you can use in Excel. So these are the simple but standard formatting, okay, when it comes to table in academic reporting, okay, simple table, okay, but easy to follow, okay, this clear and straight to the point lah. Okay, and so these are the type of table that I expect to see as well in your so this cannot be obtained directly from SPSS, okay, so you need to extract your information from SPSS and present them. So you can do Pearson correlation analysis as well. So this is quite simple to do actually. Okay, you can go to analyze. Okay, you can go to correlation, this one, correlate, and you can go for bivariate. Okay, to correlate, you are correlating between, for example, you want to look at correlation between apa tu? Gender, I mean, just testing je lah, okay. So these are the kind of correlation that you can do, okay. So how to interpret them, okay, if you do not know, okay, again, watch YouTube or you read, go through the thesis, okay, how you can actually use the correlation to actually have a more, orang kata, more discussion in your project, okay. So this is a simple thing to do as well. So again, what I plan to do is to show you how you can do the t-test, okay. So that is what I want to show you right now. So going back to this file again, okay. So basically, the one that you need to give more focus is on your Likert skill section, okay. So the first part of your questionnaire will be the demographic section. So some of the question could be in nominal, some will be in ordinal, some might be in scale format, okay, depending on the information that you want lah to have in your section number, in your first part, your demographic or your back, your demographic section in your questionnaire, okay, and then the rest will be based on your Likert skill section, okay. So let's look at the first section, okay. The first section B1 to B5, okay. So you are going to do this, repeat the process for all other sections, like C1 to C6, D1 to D8, but I'm just going to show how you can convert, okay, because the thing about Likert skill section, you have many questions under one section, okay. So which, when you key in the data, okay, your data will look something like this lah, okay. So B1 to B5. So some respondent will choose 5, some will choose 4, 3, whatever lah. Okay, and then how you actually going to use this score? Okay, 4, 4, 5, 4, so meaning for the first respondent, okay, so respondent number 1, okay, for respondent number 1, okay, for Likert section number, so from B1 to B5, okay, respondent number 1 choose 4, 4, 5, 4, 5, okay, and then the rest lah. If you got, let's say, 280 respondents, depending on your population size, okay, so meaning you will have up to 280 respondents lah to key in, okay. So So for each of the respondent, you have, for example, B1 to B5. So how are you going to use this information? Okay, one of the easiest or the common ways is to either to take the sum, okay, the sum of the marks, 4 + 4 + 5 + 4 + 5, or take the mean, the average of these marks, meaning 4 + 4 + 5 + 4 + 5 divide by 5 lah, because there are 5 components or 5 sections, 5 different questions under section B. The same goes with section C and section D. Okay, there are two ways. Okay, either you take the average, the mean, or you take the sum, SUM lah, or the total marks. Okay, but I think one of the common ways is to take the purata, the average score. Okay, from each of the section. So meaning that section B, for section B, there are 5 questions. So we are going to create one more variable. We call it, let's say, section B, meaning is the average marks of all the respondent. Meaning for one respondent, you're going to get only one value instead of 5 lah, because we cannot analyze one question at a time. Okay, depending on your analysis, maybe at PhD level, the student maybe want to analyze one question at a time. Okay, but at your level, the simple analysis, we are not interested to analyze one question at a time, but we are just looking at the whole section at a time, meaning we are only interested to look at section B. Okay, we go and read the actual write-up for this project. Look at section B is about what? I think it's about there are 3 factors which influence the cost of living. Okay, salary, whatever lah, saya pun dah tak ingat dah. Okay, so let's say section B is about the salary. Okay, the salary of the respondent. So it's divided into 5 sections. So we are going to take the mean score, purata, the average score of these 5 components, meaning we are going to lump or group them into one particular variable. Okay, so to do that, you just go to transform, click on compute variable. Okay, transform. No need to highlight lah. Okay, transform, compute variable. Okay, so you can find this video or this tutorial on YouTube as well. If you type how to convert Likert scale question and something lah. Okay, or how to calculate mean on Likert scale question. Okay, so you will find, I think, many videos showing you this simple step. Okay, so click on transform, compute variable. Okay, so target variable is the new variable name. Okay, what is the new variable name that you want to create? So let's say we just put the word, the letter B. Okay, or variable for section underscore B. Okay, so let's say I want to put section underscore B, meaning that section B, meaning I'm going to take the whole component here, and we create one variable which takes the average marks lah from B1 to B5. So you can put any name, but sometimes if you put the name too long ke apa ke, SPSS will give you an error, meaning that you cannot, the name must be, I don't know, maybe just one letter, one. If you want to put 2 parts, it must be with underscore. Okay, so section underscore B. So here we are interested to take the mean score of B1 to B5. So you must put here the numeric expression. Okay, actually you can just find the mean here. Okay, wait, mana dia? Yeah, mine lah. Okay. So just type the word mean, M-E-A-N, mean, and then bracket lah. Okay, mean, and then bracket, and then follow by just click on each of the variable, B1, and then you must put comma lah, B2, okay, B3, and then B4, up to B5, okay, and then close bracket. So what I've done is that, okay, the command is mean lah, M-E-A-N, Okay, mean, and then B1, because we have five set questions under B, if you got six, up to B6, then you click up to B6 lah. Okay, B1, comma, B2, B3, B4, comma, B5, and then close bracket, and then click OK. Okay, so what SPSS is doing now, okay, is to calculate the mean of section B. Okay, so you can close this this one. And if you go to the very right side of the data view, you can find this one, the section B. A new variable created now is using this pembaris or this ruler, means this is a scale scale data lah. Okay, remember the original data is in term of ordinal. Okay, we define our Likert scale based on ordinal definition. Okay, because strongly agree, disagree, whatever, that one is based on ordinal. But when you take the mean of the score, okay, then SPSS will create the directly under a scale definition. Okay, so you can see here, when you put on the mouse, you can see type, numeric, measure, scale. Okay, even if you go here, you can see that the last under variable view, section B, okay, is defined as scale. Okay, so what we have done just now is basically we take the purata, the mean, for all the questions under section B. 4 plus 4 plus 5 plus 4 plus 5 divide by 5, you will get the mean to be 4.4. Okay, and then the rest continue lah. So this is automatically created by SPSS for all the respondents. So if you got 200 respondent, so it will create the, it will calculate the mean for all the respondent under section B lah. Okay, so you are going to repeat this process for all other section. Section B, section C and section D. Okay, so I'm just going to show you how to do for one section. So why are we doing this for section B? Okay, because recall what I've taught you on the last video. Okay, for you to use t-test or you want to use ANOVA. Okay, both of the test is about using the mean. Okay, if you kalau kamu ingat lagi dah, okay, in your hypothesis testing, in your basic statistics, when you create your H1 or your H0, your null hypothesis or your alternate hypothesis, H0 and also your H1, okay, you always define as mu. Okay, mu, for example, if you are comparing between two population, male versus female. So let's say we want to test the, there is a difference between male and female. So mu male equals to mu female. Okay, then for H1 it will be mu male, okay, not equal to mu female. So in order to get the mu, means you need to calculate the mean. So that's why the popular choice is to use the mean, okay, not the sum of all the marks. So we take the mean, so 5, 3.8, these are all the value of the sample mean, X bar. Okay, so then you can do the hypothesis testing. For example, if you are looking at section B, okay, let's say section B is about salary, faktor gaji, okay, salary factor, okay, of the UPSB staff. Okay, so, okay, go back to the analyze tab. Okay, you go to compare means, you choose on independent sample t-test. Okay, remember in your research question number 2, I request every group to use t-test. Okay, t-test means you are comparing between two groups of your sample. Okay, remember in your variable view, okay, you can only use t-test if your value here is defined only for two groups, for example, male and female. Okay, there are only two groups. But for race, for example, okay, Malay, Chinese, Indian and others, okay, these are not suitable because actually you can do that as well, because one is for Malay, two for Chinese. Okay, but you cannot only compare Malay and Chinese and forgetting Indian and other race. Okay, but depending on your research question lah. But to make it simple, okay, for example, married and unmarried. Okay, so for example, you want to test if married and unmarried, there is a difference between married and unmarried population. Okay, or you want to, let's say, compare between, depending on the groupings. Okay, but usually it's more suitable when your data is only has two groups. Okay, male, female, apa lagi yang ada dua kumpulan. Saya pun tak nak imagine sekarang lah, depending on your, on the characteristics of your respondents. Okay, tapi let's say lah, we only stick on male and female. So male is defined as 0, female as 1. So you need to go back to your, how you define male and female, 0 and 1. Okay, so go, when you go to analyze, compare means, okay, independent sample t-test. Okay, so here, what is the test variable? So I'm looking at section B just now. Okay, section B is about salary. I'm assuming B is about salary lah, faktor gaji. Whether salary factor will influence the cost of living of the staff. Okay, maybe I get it wrong. It's not about salary, but so you need to check the report what section B is about. Okay, but whatever it is, I want to look at whether section B here, is there any difference on section B factor when it comes to gender? Okay, so gender just now is this one, jantina grouping. Okay, when you click on this variable, okay, you need to define what is the group according to your data. So just now we recall that male is 0 and group number 2 is 1, female is 1. So that's why I mentioned just now, even though you have three groups, let's say married, unmarried, and apa tu, bujang, berkahwin, dan juga janda. Okay, meaning that three groups. Or for example, Malay, Chinese, and Indian. So let's say you are only interested to compare between Malay and Chinese. So Malay, let's say, is 1, Chinese is 2. So meaning that you need to put here 1 and 2 lah, depending how you define your, let me go back here. Okay, bangsa, okay, race. Okay, so Malay is defined as 1, Chinese as 2, correct? So if you want to compare just between Malay and Chinese for whatever reason lah, okay, let's say most of your sample are Malay and Chinese, okay, very few Indians. Okay, so meaning that you only want to compare between these two race, Malay and Chinese. So again, go back to factor section B. Okay, and then you want to compare just between the Malay and the Chinese. Okay, so we go back to race just now. Okay, define groups. So Malay is defined as 1 in our data view, in our variable view, and Chinese as number 2. When you click OK, okay, so what you are doing here is you are comparing Malay and Chinese. Okay, because 1 is for Malay, 2 is for Chinese. Okay, so this is the output of your independent sample t-test. Okay, if you recall what you learn masa in your ni lah, in your basic statistics. Okay, I'm sure banyak you all ni memang dah lupa semua dah. Let me see. Yeah. Yeah, this one, the two sample hypothesis test. Okay, you are comparing between two population. Okay, so what basically you are doing is comparing between this one lah, between two population. Okay, so you are doing like mu1 equals to mu2. Okay, and then h1 mu1 not equal to mu2. So basically what we are doing is this type of test. Okay, you want to compare if there is any difference between male and female. Okay, when it comes to salary factor. Okay, section B, let's say, is about salary. So you are doing this basically. Okay, in your, so when you learn your basic statistics few semester ago. Okay, so what you are doing in this analysis is basically this ni lah, you are testing this one. Okay, tak ada, there's nothing new about the test. Okay, so this is if you're only interested to compare between, even though you have more than three groups or more than two groups, but you can still use the t-test, but you need to specify which group are you testing. So for example, if you are taking about the risk, okay, let's say that most of your sample comes from between two race only, or you have any other justification why you are only interested. Maybe because of the literature review only mentioned that only the two race has a big impact on whatever or whatever lah. Okay, depending on your issue that you want to highlight. Okay, but I'm just showing that it's still possible to use t-test, even though your questionnaire, the section in the questionnaire has more than two groups. Okay, here you can see the outcome here. Equal variance and equal variance not assumed. It's the same thing here. When you learn in your basic statistics, you learn whether you assume the variance is equal or you assume that the variance is not equal. So I'm not sure what is the strict guideline, okay? But usually we use this one, equal variance assume, okay? Because this is the only output provided, you are going to use this p-value here, okay? If the p-value is less than let's say 0.05, okay, meaning that you are going to reject the null hypothesis lah. So this is 0.01, is smaller than 0.05, meaning that you can reject the null hypothesis, or you can even use the t-table. If you recall how you can use the t-table, you look at the degrees of freedom and you look at the calculated t-value, and then you will able to know whether you are going to reject or do not reject the null hypothesis. But the easiest way is just look at the p-value. If the p-value is less than 5%, you are going to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, so that is about the using t-test. Okay, so let's go back to comparing the gender just now. So this is about the race, okay. Okay, so analyze, compare means, independent sample t-test. Okay, so we go back to the original plan, which is to test if gender has any difference. Okay, so not 1 and 2, 0 and 1. Why? Because in our data variable view, we define male as 0, female as 1. So this must follow what you define in your questionnaire, okay, in your SPSS here. So we click okay. Okay, so for this particular project, okay, the student divide equally lah, male ada 15 orang, female 15. So in your own respondent, let's say from the 250 respondent that you collected the information, so let's say it could be, you know, 180 female, 130 male, for example. So depending lah, okay, how you create your get your information from the questionnaire. Okay, the same thing here. So for factor number B, for salary factor, okay, assuming B is salary factor, okay, whether can you reject or do not reject, okay, again you look at the p-value. The p-value is 0.8, which is clearly bigger than 0.05. So you cannot reject the null hypothesis because this value is bigger than 0.05. You can only reject if the value here is smaller than 0.05. So meaning that you can reject that here, in this case, you cannot reject. So cannot reject means what? There is no difference between gender lah when it comes to salary factor. Okay, so if you forgot how to define, okay, go back to your notes in your basic statistics, see how you need to declare your conclusion. Okay, but basically if you cannot reject, mean there is no difference lah in the mean of there is no difference between gender, okay, when it comes to the salary factor lah. Okay, so this is how you can use the t-test. Okay, so I mentioned previously, at least paling cantik, I mean if possible, if you can use up to two t-tests or two hypothesis testing for t-test. It's just a simple, you just repeat the process, okay? Analyze, compare means, okay, independent sample t-test, and choose what factor, okay? That maybe one test for, let's say, section B, and another test maybe for section C. Okay, so you can use the same grouping, male, gender, between gender. Okay, one is for section B and the other one maybe for section C, or maybe three tests, section B, section C and section D. Okay, because you want to find out if each of the factor, is there any difference when it comes to gender. So if there are three sections in your Likert scale, okay, just like in this particular project here, okay, there are three Likert scale sections, section B, section C and section D. So if you create section B and section C and section D, the mean score, just what we did just now, so you can repeat the t-test, okay, for each of the section. Section B, you are looking at gender. Section C also you are looking at gender. Section C also you are looking at gender, but you get three different findings lah. One finding for one factor. Okay, so that can be done as well. So just to provide more story to your project. Okay, because this is a group work. Okay, for this particular example that you see here, this is an individual project. So every student need to analyze their own data. Okay, so that's why the sample size is quite small. But in your case, you are only analyzing this once for all groups, meaning for all the four members or five members in each group. Okay, you only do this once lah, meaning for the whole project. Okay, you only do the analysis for the entire group. Okay, there is no individual analysis. Okay, the individual assignment is only up to chapter number 3. So meaning that the workload is divided up to four to five people. So there's not much to do actually when it comes to the analysis. Maybe one person can do the analysis lah. The rest maybe preparing on the documentation, how to present in the table, how to interpret, okay, and whatnot lah. So you divide your task accordingly lah, how you want to. But the test basically is very simple to do. Okay, just go to compare mean and independent sample t-test. Okay, so next class, I think I will just finish up on this video. Okay, on this part, we are going to use ANOVA. Okay, basically it's very the same process, but we choose ANOVA lah. Okay, so I think that's it for, okay, I will upload this video, okay, hopefully by today or tomorrow. And you can practice with your own dummy data first. Okay, so you can start doing your data collection. So for the resubmission of your chapter 2, okay, I will just put on hold first, meaning no need to submit chapter 2, but maybe I just need your questionnaire. Okay, resubmit your questionnaire, not chapter 1 and chapter 2. Okay, I will put the instructions in your OL. So whatever it is, okay, I will inform you in your WhatsApp. Okay, or in your OL. Okay, so thank you. Assalamualaikum and good morning.